Chairman, first of all, allow me to support the previous speakers in congratulating you on the chairmanship of the second review conference. We reaffirm that mindful of a disproportionate impact of the use of cluster munitions on civilians and civilian objects, Azerbaijan condemns in the strongest terms any use of cluster munitions by any actor under any circumstances. In this regard, I would like to share the concerns expressed today by several delegations on the alleged use of cluster munitions in the course of recent military clashes between Armenia and Azerbaijan in and around the Nagorno-Karabakh region of Azerbaijan. As you know, during these clashes, occupation forces of Armenia were defeated and Armenia signed an act of capitulation on November 9, in accordance with which it is now in the process of withdrawing its troops from the territory of Azerbaijan. Thus, Azerbaijan has enforced the implementation of four relevant UN Security Council resolutions, thus effectively putting an end to the 20-year-long occupation of Azerbaijani territories by Armenia. As for this conference, I would like to mention that we reject the one-sided allegation expressed today by the Cluster Munition Coalition on the use of cluster munitions specifically by Azerbaijan during the military clashes, as there is no single evidence to support these allegations. And when I say as evidence, I mean serious evidences, because the tweets or the Facebook messages can hardly be taken by as a serious support base when we're talking about the international conventions. This propaganda campaign has been launched by Armenia for its own political and propaganda purposes in the midst of the military actions, which actually lead to her defeat. However, as we see today, that did not help her to escape a military defeat. We reiterate that Azerbaijani military have never targeted civilians and civilian objects in the conflict zone in full abidance with Azerbaijan's imperative obligations under the international humanitarian law. As you know, Azerbaijan is not a state party to this convention on cluster munitions, nor to the convention of on the ban of anti-personnel landmines, for the obvious reasons, because our assessment of the military posture of Armenia does not allow us, regretfully, to become a full-fledged member of both of these important international instruments and to contribute to their implementation. Returning to the conflict, I would like to say that during the active phase of military hostilities, the Ministry of Defense of Azerbaijan on several occasions appealed to civilians residing in the then occupied territories of Azerbaijan to stay clear of Armenian military infrastructure, which were legitimate targets for Azerbaijani military. The international community has witnessed numerous instances of indiscriminate and deliberate shelling by Armenia of Azerbaijani civilian targets located both in close vicinity to and far beyond the area of military operations, using short and medium range ballistic missiles and large caliber multiple launch rocket systems with cluster munition warheads that resulted in killing of 94 Azerbaijani civilians, including children, women and elderly, and injuring more than 400 people in districts and cities of Azerbaijan. Representatives of diplomatic community in Azerbaijan have made several visits to those areas and were able to collect first-hand evidence on the use of cluster munitions by Armenia against Azerbaijani civilians. They were not only diplomats, but also the military attachés of the dozens of the embassies of foreign countries in Azerbaijan. On top of it, Human Rights Watch and Amnesty International, in their statements, also confirmed the use of cluster munitions by Armenia during those missile attacks. The former leader of the armed separatists had publicly confirmed that he ordered a missile attack against the city of Ganja, which was the city where the biggest number of civilian casualties was reported, as a part of military operations. Upon this statement, a criminal case has been initiated several days ago against him by the Prosecutor General of Azerbaijan due to civilian casualties. So at the end, I would like to say, Mr. Chairman, that by targeting civilians and civilian objects, including with the use of cluster munitions, which constitutes a serious war crime under the international humanitarian law, Armenia blatantly violated its imperative obligations under the international humanitarian law, including the Geneva Conventions of 1949 and its additional protocols. So we call on the Swiss presidency of the convention and the international community to strongly condemn the use of cluster munitions by Armenia during the recent military offensive against Azerbaijan. I thank you, Mr. President.